So let's start with the unboxing of the Fantech Captain 7.1 surround sound headsets, or in other words, the Captain HG15 headsets from Fantech. So from starters, you'll see the box also has standard packaging like all the rest of Fantech's products, with the glossy feel to all the imaging on the box. If you can look at the box, you'll see that it has the RGB. I do know that the RGB is a circular movement RGB, which is quite good. It has 7.1 surround sound. It also has a noise cancelling microphone, and it has a USB port that it uses to connect to your PC. So let's get to on the unboxing of this. So if you look at the back, there's also just some features of it, and there's some pictures on the box. And when we unbox it, we'll see that the headset is wrapped in a bubble wrap material. When you remove it from the box, you have your headset and the bubble wrap, and you also have your Captain 7.1 user manual when you take it out of the bubble wrap packaging. And there's your headset. You see the headset looks quite nice, it looks quite sturdy, and we'll get to all the features within the review. There's also the nylon braided cable and the USB. So let's hop to the review right after this. So you live in South Africa and want great gaming products at great prices? Then look no farther than jam.co.za. Here you can find some of the top quality gaming products that's to offer in South Africa at very affordable prices. They also have all the Fantech ranges here, as they are the sole supplier of Fantech in South Africa. They also have amazing mouse pads you can find, which is very uniquely designed. Have a look at their website. So let's start with the review of this Fantech HG15 Captain 7.1 headset. So from starters, if you look at it, it looks amazing. The headset really looks like a decent headset. Just the looks and the feel of it, it looks like a decent build thing. And the RGB circular movements here actually is a very attractive feature of it. And also, if you look at the metal headband and everything, it's an attractive headset overall. But let's see if the headset really is worth this good looks. We'll start with the cable itself. So from starters, you'll see that the headset has a braided cable, which has a nylon coating over the braided cable. So what is good for me about this is that it is braided, so it will be very durable and it will last for very long. But over the durable braided cable, there's a nylon coating, and a nylon coating is quite thick, so it's like a nylon rubbery coating, and it actually helps that the cable doesn't tangle. So you'll see, like, when you put it down, it literally makes it straight the whole time, so the cable is very durable and it doesn't tangle at all. So I really like this feature, and I do hope we see more of this kind of cables in future. Then when you get to the headset, we'll see that the headset has a very nice metal arch here. So it's actually a metal frame, which is very durable for me compared to the Chief that we reviewed earlier. The Chief had a plastic arch arms here, and I was very concerned about that in terms of how long will it last, how durable is the plastic. And here you see it's metal frame, so it's very durable. Even if I press it at my hardest, it doesn't really bend or so it's a very durable metal, and I do feel that the metal looks good overall. So the design of it is very good compared to the headset. So when you also take the headset and you take the metal headband there and just see how durable it is, you'll see that it does have bendability and it doesn't bend at all on the headset itself. So it's very sturdy, it's very durable there, and I do feel that it will last for very long. Then underneath this metal headband or metal headband cover, you have this headband protector, or this headband that's adjustable to your head size. So basically, you can fit it to your head and it will fit most of the heads. I do feel it is big enough for all head types, small to big, so I don't see a problem with the fitment of this. And what I also like about this headband is that's a nice leather material, so it has a very durable and luxury feel to it. It has an expensive feel to it. So the headband is a very nicely designed. It has this Fantech logo there on top, and there's red threading there that also makes it look a bit more gaming, more sporty. So I really like the headband, and it's a very nice feature to have this adjustability on it. So this headband cover here is very nice. It's also very soft, so on your head it's very comfortable. You don't really feel that it's on your head, and I think it's a very nice feature of the headset. On the sides, we have your gaming headphones, just a normal plastic holder for the metal headbands there, and on the other side also said gaming headphones, just to keep the metal bands at bay. Then the headset also has very nice and soft cushions. I feel the cushions are really comfortable. When you put it on your head, you don't really feel that the headset is there. It's a very lightweight headset, so overall it's not a headset that will make your head very heavy. You don't really feel that you have it on, so I feel overall the weight of the headset is very good. But with that, the comfortability is not bad as well. The cushions of this earmuffs is very nice. It's very comfy and it's very soft. As you can see, I'm pressing it and it's very soft there. And on the inside, you also have a soft cloth material so that it doesn't scratch your ears when you do have it on. The only problem that I do have with this headset is that the design of the ear cups is basically, I would say, medium ear design. So it's not very large in terms of, if you compare it to, for instance, like the SteelSeries headset that I have on at the moment, where your ear cups are very big, so it actually fits over most ears, where this I feel is an over-ear design for more of the medium, smaller ear types. So if you do have larger ears and you're somebody that has a problem with headsets, especially with the small ear cups, I don't think it's going to be too much of an influence, the smaller ear cups, because it is very comfy. So even if it does sit over your ear, the leather really doesn't hurt you at all, because it's a very soft and comfy leather. What I do feel is that maybe after hours of gaming, that it might hurt your ear tips a bit. I haven't experienced the hurting of my ears when using this headset, but what I do tend to feel is that because it's a leather ear cup, it may cause some heating inside your ears, and some that your ears get a bit warm. So the only thing you do is just lift off your ear cups, and when you do lift off your ear cups, it will just bring fresh air and it will feel better. So you can buy this headset for just 700 rand on Jammed. The link is in the description below if you want to have a look at it, and it means it's not going to break your bank, and it's going to give you the same level of comfortability and quality as most of the high-end headsets, but yet the price is very good for this headset. So I don't feel it's going to be a big game changer, this ear cups, but just take note that it is a bit smaller than your bigger ear cups like the SteelSeries Artis 5 I have on at the moment. But overall, I don't think it's going to influence anything else, the ear cups. Then on the side, we see that the back of the ear cups are plastic, so it's a very hard plastic material. It's not something I like very much. It does feel a bit cheap, this hard plastic, but it's not really, again, it's not a game changer if you consider the price of the headset, so I won't really be too concerned about this. On the side, you have the RGB circular motion that the lights make, and I feel it's very good. It looks fantastic. So it really, if you just look at the visual perspective of this headset, I do feel that visually this headset is going to turn heads wherever you go. So when you're at a LAN event, or you're landing at friends, or at Comic-Con, or wherever you are, and you use this headset, you're going to turn heads definitely, because it just looks amazing. The only problem with the RGB that I could find is that it's not adjustable, so you can't set it to one color specifically. You only have the option of the rotating RGB. So unfortunately for that, there's no customizability for the lighting. I don't know if in future there might be a software update or something that you can install to do that. On the back of the headset, you also have the light button where you can switch on the light, the RGB light effect on the side of the headset. And you also have the volume knob here at the bottom where you can adjust your volume of the headset. It's a very sturdy button that's hidden away, so you won't just press it by accident. One thing on the headset that I do feel is something that they should have added is a mute button on the headset itself. There's no mute button here, as you can see. The only way you can mute the headset is if you physically mute it on your computer, or if you use the Fantech software for the headset and you mute it on that software. It's something that's going to bother me a bit, because I'm used to the SteelSeries that has the mute button, and sometimes when you don't have your push to talk on a Discord or a TeamSpeak or something, sometimes you do have that thing, so you just quickly need to mute when somebody approaches your room or something. So unfortunately it doesn't have the mute button, so just take note of that as well. But again, it's not a big game changer for the headset. The headset itself also has 7.1 virtual surround sound, as is advertised on the box. Now, with the virtual surround sound, what this means is that it doesn't have different drivers within the headset that makes a different surround sound sounds. It literally has software that creates this virtual surround sound while playing game. So it takes your game itself and it turns it into a virtual surround environment when you do play the game. For me, I do personally prefer and like the 7.1 sound, or the surround sound, because in games for instance, like Counter-Strike Global Offensive, whenever you sit in a corner close to where an enemy might approach, you do get the feel that you can hear a bit further on the map. So basically, when an enemy is approaching from a distance, you can hear the enemy before he even knows where you are, and you can use that to adjust. And I feel it does help a lot with your game sense when you do have the 7.1 surround sound. I know not everybody is a fan of that, but I personally do prefer it and I do like it, and I do feel that this is a very good selling point for a headset, especially a gaming headset of this caliber. And also you have this mic, and I do like this mic of this headset, I must tell you. The mic is very nice because it's adjustable, so you can literally adjust it as you need to. And the mic itself has a metal adjustable springy material, and also over it there's a nylon coating, so it makes it a bit more durable, and I think it will last a bit longer. And then the mic itself has the mic where it picks up your sound on this side. The only thing that I did notice is that your mic light is on permanently, so basically the light of your mic is not like a light that mutes it, it's literally a light that will show you the mic is on, and you can't put the light off. But again, it's not something that will put you off from using the headset, it's just something to take note of. Overall verdict of this headset for me is that the headset is a very good headset for the price. You won't really find something of this caliber for the price. I will get you the mic test now as well, just to let you hear how the mic sounds. But overall, the mic quality is, in my opinion, very good, and the headset is very comfy and sturdy. And I'll show you also now, when I put it on my head, how the headset fits. And also, I have a very big head and big ears, so you can compare that if you are somebody with a bigger head and bigger ears. So let's start with the mic test. The mic quality of the headset is really not bad for the price you pay for this headset, only 600 Rand. I do feel that the mic is very clear. It picks up my voice very nicely. And if you compare it to the SteelSeries headset I just had on previously, it really has a very nice sound to it. And I really enjoy how the quality of the mic comes through. It has a bit of a hollow sound, or a softer sound compared to the SteelSeries. But again, I think if you mix it a bit with your drivers and so, you would probably cancel it out. And compared to the Chief headset that we did review earlier, this mic sound quality is much better than the Chief. And I do feel that the mic is very good. As you know, the mic has noise cancelling, but let's just see how good the noise cancelling of the mic is. First test is this. I'm gonna scratch my beard. Hitting on the table a bit, and lastly typing on the keyboard. Now just take note, this is the optical mechanical Fantech keyboard, so the keys are quite hard. So if you hear the keys and it's very hard, just remember it's a mechanical keyboard. Here's the mic test with a normal membrane keyboard as well. And that's it for the mic test. So overall, I do feel that the mic is very good. The quality of the mic is very crisp and clear, and I feel that the mic really lives up to the headset. The headset also comes with software. Now, if you compare this to the Chief headset that we reviewed earlier, is that the Chief headset is 300 Rand in South Africa on Jammed, where you can buy this headset for just 700 Rand. And for that price difference, I'd rather suggest going for this headset with the 7.1, because it's more sturdy, it has more features, it is a metal headband here, and it has the RGB lights, and the 7.1 is a real plus point. So my overall verdict for this headset is that it's a very good headset. It's really well designed. It's very sturdy and durable. I do feel that it won't really break when you do let it fall. Only thing maybe is that this hard plastic on the side might take some damage when it does fall. The headset is really something that you can consider if you have a budget of less than 1,000 Rand. So overall, I would suggest this headset, and if you do like our videos and our reviews that we do, please like, share, subscribe and comment on our videos. Please be sure to put that bell notification on YouTube so that you will be notified when you do future reviews, because there's going to be a lot more reviews coming your way. Thank you everybody for tuning in.